my time and it's definite. I will never miss.
Debit list, no credit fixed, where fiends won't fail to misuse. They settled on a corner with magazines, they ain't selling issue. Told them not to meddle with it, as the lead excels through tissue. Said that I will never miss, ironic, I'll forever miss you. While you was in a cell, I feel I bailed. All we had was distance, and you took a hit, your liver failed. But the habit didn't, had your inhibitions. I'm so mad I didn't listen, life was grabbing my attention. Should've had an intervention.
What's going on, YouTube? It's Wally Noxo, and we're back with the reaction series. So today, man, listen, obviously there's been so much talk of Cole and Kendrick. I feel like there's a third party who keeps getting left out of this situation. Yes, that's right. I'm talking about the one and only Drake. Now, look, I think what's important to keep in mind is that in a diss battle, right, it's like a game, right? You have a favorite, and of course you have your overwhelming favorites, but that's why you play the game, because sometimes underdogs can surprise you. Sometimes underdogs can win. And really, in a diss battle, you don't know what's coming. You don't know how narratives get changed. Anything can happen. It is chaos incarnate. It is wild. That's why people love to step back and watch the drama. And you don't always know who's going to come out on top. Point being, there was a rapper who was really buzzing at the time. I'm talking about Meek Mill out of Philly, right? He was having beef and issues with Drake. And a lot of people were like, well, Meek is going to wash Drake on tracks. Meek is absolutely going to wrap circles around him because he's a real MC. He's a real rapper. Drake is more pop. He's more singing. He's more making hits. There's no way he's ready for this type of energy and this type of battle. Well, we're going to look at diss track Drake. Right here, right now, it's none other than his Meek Mill responses and disses and Charged Up and Back to Back. You hear that sample? How it sounds like it's played in reverse? That's because it is. I love sort of that style of just taking a sound and reverse engineering it. And then it gives you a different intonation. I'm so sorry. Did you hope I was crying? It was rough without you. Drake and the troll game is strong on this one. And one more comment on the production, because this is a very Drake-esque style, right? You take the sounds, and it sounds like it's been doused underwater. Like it's coming from the apartment next door. You know, there's just that sort of subdued layering to it. And I feel like we're about to get Drake just like R&B singing on this song. He's about to run around like a Cupid, but instead of pulling out a bow and arrow, he's got an AK-47 with diss track Drake, baby.
I did some charity today for the kids, but I'm used to it, cause all y'all charity cases, all y'all stare in my face. I hope you could be the replacement. Niggas is snitching on us without no interrogation. I stay silent cause we at war and I'm very patient. Six God is watching, I just hope you're prepared to face him. I'm charged up. I'm charged up.
Talking about charity cases, I think one of the funniest moments for me is the fact that literally in Philly at Meek Mill's school, Drake is the one who donated to charity to help fund a local music studio for the school. Drake talked about charity cases, getting on collabs with these artists like Meek Mills. He's doing a charity case. He's doing you favors, right? You still want to complain and make this tweet that he's not promoting your album. Well, he got on the album. Anyways, is that not enough promotion for you? Come on now.
I stay silent because we at war and I'm very patient. Six God is watching. I just hope you're prepared to face him. I'm charged up.
Love how you have the battery charged up. And even before that, when he talks about, you know, snitches, no interrogation. Because Meek Mill, in Drake's eyes, is trying to snitch on him when he never confronted him directly, right? Instead of coming to the source and getting the facts right, he took to social media to vent his frustrations. What type of behavior is that from someone who's supposed to be reflective of the streets of Philly? You can see the holes that are opening up for Drake to exploit as we continue, because we all know the rule of no snitching in the streets, right? So let's see where we go.
Because all y'all charity cases, all y'all stare in my face, I hope you could be the replacement. Niggas is snitching on us without no interrogation. I stay silent because we at war and I'm very patient. Six God is watching, I just hope you're prepared to face him. I'm charged up. I'm charged up. Wow. I'm honored that you think this is staged. I'm flattered, man. In fact, I'm amazed. The perfect start to the summer, man. This shit is a doozy. This shit is...
Wow. I'm honored that you think this is staged. Just even like the satirical, ironic way that he says that. I mean, again, he's trolling, man. There's a lot of charisma to this diss track and just the way that he's taken the critique on him and kind of flipping it back on a Meek. It's like a disappointed father speaking to his son right now.
And in fact, I'm amazed. The perfect start to the summer, man. This shit is a doozy. This shit a twist in the movie, but don't jump to conclusions. You boys are getting any of your feelings on me. You should embrace it. This could be one of our realest moments. Okay, the flow start to feel familiar, don't it? Must I remind you that Jimmy got 20 million on it?
The flow starting to feel familiar, don't it? Right? I mean, again, you talk about production, but there's also certain flow pockets and rhythmic patterns that are definitely the Drake style. And to me, it's like, you heard this flow because this has been on your features before, but you're having flashbacks now and you want to talk about ghostwriters, but the flow sounded familiar. And who's the one who's patented this flow? Not these ghostwriters that you're claiming. The rest of the general public is going to tell you it's attributed to the man from the six, the man from Toronto. And then even Wheelchair Jimmy, right? His days on Degrassi. Jimmy got 20 million on it. You can put that on him. Started from the bottom, now we're here, right?
Feelings on me. You should embrace it. This could be one of our realest moments.
And that line I like too. You should embrace this. Could be one of our realest moments. What's he implying here? Right? He's implying you're fake. Right? If you've had all these issues with me, then why not bring it up? And now it takes this situation and this drama and this diss track to really bring it up. Well, finally we can get real with each other. Finally we can tell each other how we really feel.
Is it getting any of your feelings on me? You should embrace it. This could be one of our realest moments. Okay, the flow start to feel familiar, don't it? Must I remind you that Jimmy got 20 million on it? Need DJ Clue to drop a bomb on it. None of them want this shit more than I want it. I seen it all coming, knew they would push a button. East egg hunting, they gotta look for something. Done doing favors for people.
Hey man, Easter's around the corner. My kids are gonna be excited. They're gonna go Easter egg hunting. But in this case, there's a different type of evidence that Drake is pointing out here, right? Y'all are reaching. You're trying to find this, but come with receipts or don't come at all. And for me, the important lines is the DJ drama, dropping bombs, especially like mixtape days when you get a DJ to host and they drop like bombs and would hype it up. Even Kendrick talked about it in his control verse. But this is important because DJ drama is a rival to Funk Flex. Now, Funk Flex took a very active involvement in this beef. He's the one who started backing Meek Mills, who's saying that he's got receipts and he tried to publish the Quentin Miller reference tracks for some of these Drake songs that he's been involved with. And you can hear Quentin Miller laying down the references, laying down sort of the rhythmic patterns and flows. And then some people went and dissected. They were like, well, Drake's not taking all the lines. But I think the important thing was, is that he didn't necessarily take the lines, but he definitely took those flow patterns. He definitely learned from those setups of how to ride the beat, which is what a reference track is and what a reference track helps to set up when you're working with ghostwriters. I mean, drama pulled those down afterwards, but I think you can still go find a number of them on the internet. They're still out there. I might do some digging and post some of that below if you guys want to check it out and just look more into it. But it's important that Drake is talking about one of drama's rivals in terms of Funk Flex, right? Because for me, that's another just subtle chess move from Drake, like not naming Funk Flex, but like acknowledging. I'll see you in the background.
East egg hunting, they gotta look for something. Done doing favors for people, cause it ain't like I need the money I make off a feature. I see you niggas having trouble going gold, turning into some so-and-sos that no one knows. But so it go, come live all your dreams out at OVO. We gon' make sure you get your bread and you know the ropes. I get a ring and I bring it home like I'm Corey Joe. No woman ever had me starstruck, or was able to tell me to get my bars up. I'm charged up. Oh no, we eating. Niggas ain't about to starve us. Nah. Niggas ain't about to starve us.
All right, we'll bring it back and appreciate and break down some more of these bars. I just wanted to let it flow and feel it. Because what's interesting to me is that, you know, this is just Drake flowing, just feeling it, right? It's very laid back vibes, like I said, right? It doesn't feel like your typical diss track. But I think this is a smart move from Drake because lean into your lane, right? Don't necessarily step out of your lane and the type of music that you make. Because he's making songs that still sound really good. And I think that's what leads to the success of Back to Back, which we're going to follow up with, because he's just making hit records, but he's dissing at the same time.
Live all your dreams out at OVO. Favors for people, because it ain't like I need the money I make off a feature. I see you niggas having trouble going gold.
That's an important line, because if you look at the stats, numbers don't lie, right? Meek Mill trying to push albums just to reach gold that happens even years later versus Drake, who drops platinum records.
Turning into some so-and-sos that no one knows. But so it go. Come live all your dreams.
So it go. Reminds me of the Spanish saying, lo que será, será. Well, will be. You know, so it goes. Just let it ride out into the wind.
No one knows. But so it go. Come live all your dreams out at OVO. We gonna make sure you get your bread and you know the ropes. I get a ring and I...
You want a deeper line on that? We're going to make sure you get your bread and you know the ropes. In this case, Quentin Miller came over and worked with Drake at OVO. Quentin Miller started off working in a bakery, so he got his bread doubled down in a different way.
Out at OVO, we going to make sure you get your bread and you know the ropes. I get a ring and I bring it home like I'm Corey Joe.
Nope. And Corey Joe, right? Toronto, bass, NBA reference right there. Won a championship with the San Antonio Spurs. And then he went back to Toronto and played for the Raptors. Drake talking about the rings, baby. Come on.
Bread and you know the ropes. I get a ring and I bring it home like I'm Corey Joe. No woman ever had me starstruck or was able to...
Nicki Minaj line right there.
Tell me to get my bars up. I'm charged up. Oh no, we eating. Niggas ain't about to starve us.
Because you got to remember right there, Nicki was dating Meek Mill at the time. And this will come back into play too.
Nah. Niggas ain't about to starve us. I'm charged up. I bought my niggas rollies off of Thank Me Later while these boys were stanky legging. Trust me, this information is vital. I'm trying to take the high road. I still got love for my idols. I got me a deal with Apple and I still feel entitled. Rumor has it there's something that only I know. Rumor has it I steer the ship with my eyes closed. Rumor has it I either fucked her or never could. But rumor has it hasn't done you niggas any good. It sounds, sounds, sound to the day I die. We going live to keep your shit alive. Cops are killing people with their arms up. And your main focus is trying to harm us. And you think you about to starve us? Niggas ain't about to starve us. Nah, I'm charged up.
There's some more bars we got to break down from that verse right there. Let's bring it back and hop in.
Trust me, this information is... I'm charged up. I bought my niggas rollies off of Thank Me Later. Why these...
Meek Mills always has bars about the rollies, right? So I think that's also another just like subtle move from Drake to try to get under his skin. He's going to brag about his success, but then he's also going to let Meek know that he's doing research on him. I know what you talk about, right? I know what you like to flaunt. You love your rollies, right? So I'm going to talk about my success and the level of rollies that I can get from my team just based off of the albums that I put out. And let's compare that to yours.
I bought my niggas rollies off of Thank Me Later while these boys were stanky legging. Trust me, this information is vital. I'm trying to take the high road. I still got love for my idols. I got me a deal with Apple and I still feel entitled.
Got me a deal with Apple and I still feel entitled. I just love that more harmonic, just like come up on the cadence right there. But Tidal, streaming services, they were trying to lock in a deal with Drake, but he signed a huge deal with Apple. And obviously, Tidal is linked with Jay-Z, Jay-Z being one of Drake's idols, so he still got love for him and he flips it back in that way. And then this information is vital. To me, there's something subtle underneath that. It's like, I got something against you that you don't want out, but I'm trying to take the high road, right? I'm trying not to get involved in this situation, but you're dragging me into it.
High road, I still got love for my idols. I got me a deal with Apple and I still feel entitled. Rumor has it there's something that only I know. Rumor has it I steer the ship with my eyes closed. Rumor has it I either fucked her or never could. But
I steer the ship with my eyes closed. Rumor has it there's something I know that only I know, that only I have. Is it the Ghost Rider situation? What is it? But to me, again, there's like a warning. Something I know that I know about you. But at the end of the day, it's all rumors, right? Rumors this, rumors that. And then he says something he knows is going to get under Meek's skin again, right? The infamous rumors of whether or not he has slept with Nicki Minaj. Because obviously, they're at Cash Money. There's a lot of links between them. There's been a lot of rumors over the years. Drake playing into those rumors, saying it to make a point about the rumors. Because at the end of the day, look what he's doing. He's trying to discredit the ghostwriter claims of Meek Mill. So it's very clever, right? Take this and flip it back on the opponent. And in this case, he's flipping it back in a different way. He's using the rumor situation to point out a different type of rumor that he knows is going to get under Meek's skin. And Meek will say, we'll come with the receipts, prove it, because she said it didn't happen. Just like Drake turning around going, well, you say I have a ghostwriter, come with the receipts, prove it, right? It's all rumors. Think about the way that he's spinning and flipping that.
Feel entitled. Rumor has it there's something that only I know. Rumor has it I steer the ship with my eyes closed. Rumor has it I either fucked her or never could. But rumor has it hasn't done you niggas any good. It's sound, sound, sound to the day I die.
Sound, 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 OVO sound.
We going live to keep the shit alive.
I like that flip.
Cops are killing people with their arms up. And your main focus is trying to harm us.
That's an interesting bar. Feels a little out of place because Drake, it's not like Drake gets political a lot. It's not like Drake really speaks out. I mean, yeah, he's talked about the cops and police brutality before. He has had bars about it. It's not like he's made whole songs about it. But Meek has also spoken about that too. But Drake is just trying to say, you know, there's bigger movements happening. Like, you want to focus on this and this situation between us when there's a lot more happening in the world out there.
And people with their arms up. And your main focus is trying to harm us. And you think you're about to starve us. Niggas ain't about to starve us. Nah. I'm charged up.
It's like he's in a relationship, isn't it? The way that he's spinning this with these quotes here. Like I said, man, the laid-back vibes lull them into this false sense of security. I mean, he's still spitting some bars. He's still attacking. It's just like a laid back way of attacking. He's like, I got to deal with my obsessed ex right now. Right. And to me, this is like your typical bait first track. Right. Like there's enough there to keep him intrigued, to make him fire back. But to me, I feel like at this point, Drake already has back to back on deck, which is a lot more hyped, a different type of energy and a different type of vibe. And I think it's a really smart move in a battle from Drake. Right. He's got this type of sound that goes in this lane in this way. And he's going to follow it up with something a lot more energized. Something that's actually a lot more charged up, ironically. That's really going to make people notice. Because he's about to go back to back. And so are we.
Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Not again. Yeah, I learned the game from William Wesley. You can never check me. Back to back for the niggas that didn't get the message. Back to back like I'm on the cover of Lethal Weapon. Back to back like I'm Jordan 96, 97. Whoa, very important and very pretentious. When I look back, I might be mad that I gave this attention. Yeah, but it's weighing heavy on my conscience. Yeah, and fuck you left the boy no options. I wanna see my niggas go insane. You gon' make me step out of my fucking frame. You gon' make me buy bottles for Charlemagne. You gon' make me go out of my fucking way. I waited 4 days, nigga, where y'all at? I drove here in a rave playing ARF. I'm not sure what it was that really made y'all mad. But I guess this is what I gotta do to make y'all rap. I mean, ooh, can't fool the city, man, they know what's up. Second floor, Tootsie's getting shoulder rubs. Ooh. It's for y'all to think that I don't write enough. They just mad cause I got the Midas touch. You love her, then you gotta get a world tour. Is that a world tour or your girl's tour? I know that you gotta be a thug for her. This ain't what she meant.
All right, I don't want to get copyrighted. I'm just trying to let it play and just feel the vibe of this. Because, again, like, when this dropped, everybody took notice, right? This was Meek Mill's nail in the coffin, really. And just the way that he came back on this. And we heard Charged Up. And the energy's here on Charged Up, isn't it? I think this was just a great move from Drake. Just from a musicality and just producing perspective to choose this type of beat and vibe and attack it in this way. Because again, it's a bounce. It's a vibe, man. He's making another hit song. It's catchy, but at the same time, he's trolling, right? He's firing shots. He's dissing as well. And you can tell he's just having a hell of a lot of fun with it. I mean, even the album cover to me is genius, right? I'm going to see if I can find it because it's got a picture of Joe Carter, right? And what's important is that original image is Joe Carter after he hit the home run to win the World Series against the Philadelphia Phillies. So the Toronto Blue Jays beating the Philadelphia Phillies in the World Series, right? Meek Mill being from Philly versus Drake being from Toronto. And the other important thing is that that was the second consecutive World Series that the Blue Jays had won. So they literally went back to back, like Drake going back to back on this track because Meek Mill still hasn't responded. So Drake going, you know what? It's fine. You're not going to respond? I'll handle it for you. I got this. I mean, even like the way the title is, the word back is arranged so it's backwards, so it's back to back. Oh man, I just love it. There are levels and levels to this one. All right, more bars on this.
Not again. Yeah, I learned a game from William Wesley. You can never check me. Back to back for the...
That line, William Worldwide West. If anybody knows the NBA, this is like the secret man behind the scenes with all the connections, influence, and powers, right? He's as close to the NBA Illuminati, I feel like, as you can get, right? He's got Michael Jordan on speed dial. He's got LeBron James on speed dial. Jay-Z, like, he can connect you with anyone and everyone. So in this case, I learned the game, like the rap game versus literally the game of basketball. It's a clever flip. You can never check me. Like, cover someone, guard them in basketball versus check me. Money is in checks. Smooth right there.
Yeah, I learned a game from William Wesley. You can never check me. Back to back for the niggas that didn't get the message. Back to back like I'm on the cover of Lethal Weapon. Back to back like I'm Jordan.
Back to back like the cover of Lethal Weapon. Literally in Lethal Weapon 3, Mel Gibson and Danny Glover standing back to back. Drake following up his diss tracks back to back and then setting it up like Jordan, who won championships in 96 and 97. And actually, Jordan three-peated and went on in 98 to win. And a lot of people speculated that Drake had a track and a diss track three-peat that he even previewed at his show, trolling Meek Mills. If the battle continued, Drake was ready to come with a three-peat, much like MJ. Let's keep it going from here.
They didn't get the message. Back to back like I'm on the cover of Lethal Weapon. Back to back like I'm Jordan 96, 97. Whoa, very important and very pretentious. When I look back, I might be mad that I gave this attention. Yeah, but it's weighing heavy on my conscience. Yeah, and fuck, you left the boy no options. I wanna see my niggas go insane. You gon' make me step out of my fucking frame. You gon' make me buy bottles for Charlemagne. You
gon' make me step out of my frame, right? That to me, because Drake is making hits. Drake is more of a pop mainstream sensation, isn't he? He's not a battle rapper. He's not a diss track rapper. And yet he's stepping out of his lane for this. And even stepping out of his lane because he's not cool with Charlemagne normally. But the enemy of my enemy is my friend, right? In this case, Charlemagne has a huge rivalry with Funk Flex. So what's Drake doing? You gonna make me link up with my enemy just to get back at you all.
But no options. I wanna see my niggas go insane. You gonna make me step out of my fucking frame. You gonna make me buy bottles for Charlemagne. You gonna make me...
It's a wave, Charlemagne. Just the way that he holds it out and rides his beat, man.
Go out of my fucking way. I waited 4 days, nigga, where y'all at? I drove here in a rave playing ARAB. I'm not...
ARAB from Philly also has beef with Meek Mill at the time, and OVO actually signed ARAB, so it goes even deeper there.
4 days, nigga, where y'all at? I drove here in a rave playing ARAB. I'm not sure what it was that really made y'all mad, but I guess this is what I gotta do to make y'all rap. I mean, oh, can't fool the city, man.
That's one of the hardest hitting lines for me, right? You're telling another rapper, a rapper. Remember going into this, people are like, Meek is gonna wash Drake. Drake just sings, right? So you're telling another rapper, this is what I have to do to make you rap? I mean, that's one of the greatest trolling lines I think I've ever heard in a diss track right there. Because y'all ain't rapping, so you know what? I'll do it for you again. I'll make another diss. Here you go. You want that energy? Let's get it.
But I guess this is what I gotta do to make y'all rap. I mean, oh, can't fool the city, man. They know what's up. Second floor, Tootsie's getting shoulder rubs.
Second floor, Tootsie's getting shoulder rubs. There's a famous strip club, Tootsie's, so he's on the second floor getting shoulder rubs. But a lot of people speculated there's a restaurant, Miss Tootsie's, in Philly. So Drake's saying he's important. Maybe he's in Philly and that bar goes deeper.
Think that I don't write enough. They just mad he's getting shoulder rubs. Just for y'all to think that I don't write enough. They just mad because I got the Midas touch.
It's for y'all to think that I don't write enough, right? They mad because I got the Midas touch. Everything that I write turns to gold. Again, there's my success. My records turn gold. They go beyond that, right? I just make hits. You say that I have ghostwriters? Well, this is for you. I'm not ghostwriting this. I came back with this immediately. This is how quick I can snap. I walked in the studio and did it.
This for y'all to think that I don't write enough. They just mad because I got the Midas touch. You love it and you gotta get a world tour. Is that a world tour or your girl's tour? I know that you gotta be a thug for her. This ain't what she meant when she told you to open up.
No, I can't do it. I can't do it. That's the bar. That's the bar, man. I spat my milk out. I was having breakfast that morning when I heard that song. That was it, man. Cheerios flying all over the place, right? This ain't what she meant She told you to open up more because Meek Mill is on Nicki Minaj's world tour, his girlfriend, and he's the opening act, right? No, she wants you to be more emotional and open up about how you're feeling. Not go on tour with her and open for her.
Thug for her. This ain't what she meant when she told you to open up more. Yeah. Trigger fingers turn to Twitter fingers. Yeah. You getting body by a singing nigga.
Oh, the memes. The memes on that one. And Drake tapped his inner Jay-Z when Jay-Z was at Summer Jam Scream, right? And was trolling Prodigy and had that up in his childhood picture up on the screen. What did Drake do after this dropped? He went and did his OVO show, right? And had Meek Mill's memes and just trolled the shit out of him and playing off of this and trigger fingers, right? Because you're supposed to be about the streets. See what he's doing again? He's calling into question his character. You're someone who represents this. You're someone who's supposed to be an MC, yet you're not rapping on the track. You're someone who's supposed to be from the streets of Philly, and you always talk about this life, and yet the second there's heat, you take to social media? Is that really how you move? That's your first port of call. That's the first thing you're going to do in this situation.
World tour. Is that a world tour or your girl's tour? I know that you gotta be a thug for her. This ain't what she meant when she told you to open up more. Yeah. Trigger fingers turn to Twitter fingers.
Oh, I'm having fun today.
Yeah. You getting bodied by a singing nigga. I'm not the type of nigga that'll type of niggas. Shout to all my boss, bitches, wife, and niggas.
Make sure you hit. That was even the Nicki Minaj sort of wife and da da da. Like the way that he just says that. That's a very Nicki Minaj tone because he's shouting out Nicki, right? She's a boss bitch, right? He doesn't fire shots at his label mate, but what he is doing, very cleverly, saying, we know who runs this relationship here, right? I'm not typing. I'm not getting in my feelings, right? We know who the real boss is of that, and you're supposed to be Mr. Street. You're not the one running even your own relationship.
Fingers. Yeah, you getting bodied by a singing nigga. I'm not the type of nigga that'll type of niggas. And shout to all my boss, bitches, wife, and niggas. Make sure you hit them with the dead, tell that man to ease up. I did another one. You still ain't did shit about the other one. Got the drink in me going back to back. Yeah, going back to back. I got the drink in me going back to back. Yeah, I'm going back to back. I don't wanna hear about.
I love how he just throws in a little hook. I'm going back to back. It's so simple, right? It's catchy, but at the same time, it makes you think. He really is going back to back on these disses. And then everything just drops out. No percussion here, right? Just like, feel the vibes. Get melodic with it. And then when he's ready to start dissing some more, drop that percussion. Let it all kick back in.
Back to back. Yeah, I'm going back to back. I don't want to hear about this ever again. Not even when she tell him that they better as friends. Not even when you're saying Drizzy, tell him again.
They better as friends. I mean, come on, the typical break. It's not you. It's me. We should just be friends, right? And what happens later on? Nicki does end up breaking up with Meek Mill.
When she tell him that they better as friends. Not even when you're saying Drizzy, tell him again. I've been putting on the show, it was a sellout event. Oh, you need better seating. I didn't want to do it, gave me every reason.
You need better seating, right? I'm selling out my shows. What are you doing? You can't even get nosebleeds at my shows.
You need better seating. I didn't want to do it, gave me every reason. What I'm trying to make is I don't ever need them. Seeing what you do for fame or what you do for freedom. Please check them for a while or an earpiece.
Please.
Please do not let these niggas nail me. Please.
Again, you see the flips here? You see the flips in what he's doing, calling into question his character? Check him for a wire and earpiece. Mr. Street over here. You see what he'll do for fame? He's so desperate for this and for my attention that he's going to turn to Twitter and be so desperate he's going to spread these false stories and narratives about me. Well, he's been to jail before. What would he do to buy his freedom? If he's so desperate to do this, something even greater than that, freedom, he'd probably do anything for it. Like snitch, like cop a plea, like cop a deal. I mean, it's very clever again because Drake is taking Meek Mill exposing something and taking a negative on him and saying he's a snitch. But the snitch goes even further. Think about what he's doing to try to get famous with me. What would he do for freedom? He would snitch as well. And expose anyone and do whatever it takes, even if he doesn't have receipts. Very clever thought process from Drake and flips again.
Trying to make a sound, never need him. Seeing what you do for fame or what you do for freedom, please. Check him for a while or an earpiece, please. Please do not let these niggas nail me, please. Think before you come for the great one, please. Who's a real nigga and who ain't one, please. Somebody stop me. I'm talking.
talking bossy and Guanajuasi. I got the fest in 5 days.
Guanajuasi, I'm talking bossy. Again, man, I learned this when I played up in Toronto. That was my first contract, remember, right? And a lot of my teammates, they're from the Caribbean. So all of a sudden, I start hearing this, like, this patois. I start hearing this Caribbean, this Jamaican slang, man, and all kinds of different words, right? And he's talking his shit right now. He's going crazy on it, right? Love it. Very huge part of Toronto in the Sixth culture, man.
Talking bossy and Guanajuasi. I got the fest in 5 days and it's my shit. Soon as a nigga hit the stage, they gon' ask if I can play the shit.
I got the fest in 5 days and it's my shit, right? The whole city has his back. Hell, at the time, man, there's a hilarious suite. One of the Toronto city councilors even tells Meek that he is not welcome in Toronto. I mean, this shit is going crazy, man.
Back to back, yeah. They want it back to back. They gon' ask if I can play this shit back to back. I took a break from views, now it's back to that nigga.
And the thing is, that's funny about this, is that Meek Mill finally responds to this with one and no. The problem is that it just flopped. It wasn't receiving good attention. It was getting a lot of hate, a lot of memes made after it. So Meek Mill, in the ultimate L, pulled that diss track from the internet and removed it. And I don't think he's ever recovered from that Drake beef since. Hope you guys liked today's video. Listen, I'm a little sick. I'm under the weather. I'm pushing through it for you guys. If you appreciate all the grind that I'm putting in this week, then do me a huge favor. Support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. Really, really does go a long way. I love you guys. Stay safe, stay positive. It's Willie Knoxville. You know, I'll catch you again.